So today in this video, I'll be going over, does Magnum xl200 need new trains?
What is up, y'all? It's your boy Mystic Timbers Fanboy, and I'm going to go over why I think Magnum xl200 at Cedar Point needs new trains. So first of all, I'm going to go over the stats and what the roller coaster wars was. So basically, the height of Magnum xl200 is 205 feet. The speed is 72 miles per hour. And it opened on May 6, 1989. Basically, the roller coaster wars was in which amusement parks competed with each other at a rapid pace to build the next tallest and fastest roller coaster. So that's basically the easiest and simplest definition of what the roller coaster wars was actually about. So first of all, I'm going to say, in my opinion, my experiences on Magnum XL200. Magnum XL200 is kind of like a ride. You kind of love it or you hate it. The only problem I have with Magnum XL200, I love the layout. The theming, I don't know. I know the theming is not really that good. I like that it's close to a lake. It's close to Lake Erie. That's the thing I really like about it. It's really amazing. It's like amazing experience. I love the ejector airtime moments at the end. That's the most infamous part of the ride, in my opinion. I really love the airtime hills. It's a little bit more forceful than Diamondback. I'm not saying Magnum XL200 is the most forceful hyper coaster, but it's way forceful than Diamondback compared to Diamondback. Diamondback's airtime was completely forceless, in my opinion, while Magnum's ejector airtime was intense. Like, they're intense. It's kind of a good ejector airtime mode. The only problem I have is the restraints. The restraints are just trash and suck, in my opinion. There's a few people that will disagree with me, saying that the trains are awesome, they look good, but in my opinion, the trains just suck. The restraints suck. The trains are like a thigh crusher. In my opinion, it almost makes the ride unbearable. It's not unbearably rough where I don't want to ride it, like in Vertigo. Not that type of unbearably rough. But still, in my opinion, I do not like the trains at all. I really hate the trains. So I'm going to go over the reason what new trains Magnum XL200 can get. So first of all, I'm going to go over the B&M clamshells. So I'm going to go over the pros and cons of the B&M clamshells. So if Magnum XL200 got the B&M clamshells, that would be amazing if they got the B&M clamshells. The B&M clamshells would really, really improve the ride's quality. It would improve everything about the ride. The ride would be a little smoother. It would be a little smoother, but not perfectly smooth. Like maybe Fury or Diamondback. I mean, still going to be rough a little bit. But it's not going to be unbearably rough where no one really wants to ride it. I like the B&M clamshells. I'm kind of a fan of the B&M clamshells. The only problem, the con, Magnum XL200, which is an aerodynamics hypercoaster, got the B&M clamshells. There's always going to be a con. So basically the cons of that would be the track design. Aerodynamics track design is way different than, let's say, Morgan or B&M's track design. So that would be really of a con, is the track design, is because B&M would have to specially customize the trains for Magnum XL200, and it would be a challenge for B&M to try and renovate Magnum XL200. I really don't see that happening. And the second reason I would be against Magnum XL200 to get the B&M clamshells is because it would kill the airtime. The airtime is the most probably iconic part of the ride in the tunnels. The clamshells would automatically just kill the airtime. And Magnum XL200 wouldn't be that good like it used to be. So those are the only two cons I have against Magnum XL200 getting the B&M clamshells. And basically, the other one I'm going to go over is the S&S trains. I think this is most likely if they were going to get new trains. So S&S, which basically bought aerodynamics, is in control of aerodynamics, not in control. But S&S basically owns aerodynamics. And I think Magnum XL200 should get the S&S lap bar restraints. I think this would be really good. Like I said, it would drastically improve the ride's experience. I mean, drastically. It wouldn't be rough, it would be smooth. And I wouldn't say I really don't have a con with it. The pros are that the trains can fit on Magnum XL200. I'm thinking that S&S will do the same thing like they did to Titan Max, which is a defunct aerodynamics hyper coaster, which was once in Japan. But basically, I think Magnum XL200's trains need to be changed in general. I would be against them getting the clamshell restraints. I think the S&S trains are more likely. I think the S&S trains would basically just the quality, quality would be better. I'm not gonna say the quality, but the ride experience would be better. Basically, what my main point is, Magnum XL200 wouldn't be that rough. I'm not gonna say it's not gonna be the best roller coaster in the park. For example, like maybe Millennium Force Topple Dragster or Steel Vengeance, but I still think this ride needs a renovation, in my opinion. So that's really all I have to say in this video. Thank you guys. Make sure you guys like and subscribe. My main goal is to get 100 subscribers. I know we can get there. A few of my videos have gotten 100 views, but I mean, we still can get there. It's always gonna take time. See you guys later. Peace out. Bye.